Welcome to this session of my video series. A switch statement is a decision statement. It is convenient to use a switch where you would need nested if and else. Multiple paths can be chosen at this decision point. This is a typical switch statement. This is the body of the switch statement. The curly braces contain the body of the switch. The control is determined by this expression. It is called the switch expression. The next statement to be executed is determined by the value of this expression. It must be a number type. Strings cannot be used in C. This is a case label. Its label is 99. A case label ends in a colon. This is another case label for 45. All case labels end in a colon. If I is 99, then this code executes. If I is 45, then this code executes. If it is neither 45 nor 99, then the default label executes. This is a break statement. The break statement takes you out of the switch statement. This is another example of a switch. It has three case labels and a default label. No break statement has been written after this case label. If I is 65, this code will execute. This break will take you out of the switch. But if I is 45, the code for case 65 will also execute. There is no break statement to take you out. This is called a fall through. This is another fall through. If I is 76, the control will fall through to the default label. Let's see a program on the use of switch. Take an input from the user. Display a weekday according to the number entered by the user. Obtain a number input from the user. Create a switch on the number entered by the user. This code executes if the number is 0. This is for the value 1. This is displayed when any other number is entered by the user. Obtain a char input from the user and tell if it is a vowel or consonant. This program takes an input from the user. The input is a character. And it uses a switch to print the output. Obtain a character input from the user. Store it in a variable called k. HR is a numeric. Compiler treats it as an ASCII value. So we can use it as the switch expression. All these case labels fall through. Every vowel input will fall through here. Notice the use of both upper and lower case characters in case labels. It's a good programming practice to foresee all possibilities. This code gives correct output even if there is an accidental caps lock. We usually see the default label at the end of a switch. But it is not mandatory to place it there. It can appear anywhere inside the switch. In this code, the default label appears at the beginning of the switch. You can place it anywhere as per your convenience. This flexibility is of use when you want to club it with a fall through. This default label appears at the start of this switch. The default label is not compulsory. Don't add it if you don't need it. Variables like int, float, double, char, etc., are called primitives. Such types of variables can be declared inside a switch. In this code, I and C have been declared inside the switch. They are available only to the case labels in this switch. These I and C are available to the case labels in this switch. Only declaration is possible. You cannot give values to the variables at this place. Thank you.